You're listening to the Chad Easty Show on demand. Good for you. Now download the KFYO app and listen live weekday afternoons, 5 to 7 p.m. Central.
Broadcasting from the great state of Texas, this is the Chad Easty Show. News and views with a Lone Star perspective. You can sound off during the show by sending Chad a text at 806-680-2790. That's 806-680-2790. Or call in at 1-800-687-0790. Now, here's Chad Easty.
Good evening, Lubbock, Amarillo, Abilene, Wichita Falls, Midland, Odessa, down in Houston, over in Dallas, Fort Worth, El Paso, wherever you may be listening, whether you're inside the great state of Texas or outside Texas, we welcome you into the Chad Easty Show today on this Monday, September 16th of 2024. A pretty nice day that we've had today. A lot to get into on the show as we have yet another attempted assassination attempt on former President Donald Trump in the news. Yesterday, the big breaking story that took over the afternoon. Of course, there were some in the news media who at first they wanted to say this wasn't a real story and that Trump was really in no danger. It turns out this is a just like the first assassination attempt. This really was a God thing, a luck. Whatever you want to say played into this, we're very lucky. We're very, very lucky as a nation today. We're very, very lucky as a people that this assassination attempt did not go as planned, did not work out. We're very lucky that a Secret Service agent was able to spot the barrel of an AK-47 through a chain link fence. We're very lucky on that. We've got more details out today about this would-be shooter who is just an absolute crazy person. And I don't mean you got to commit him crazy. I mean he is bought all in to the Trump is the devil, Trump is Hitler, Trump will kill off Ukraine, Trump will end democracy, Trump is Hitler. He's bought into all of it. His son has bought into all of it. And the FBI has known about the guy since at least 2019. The guy is a nut. He is an absolute crazy person. And he waited at least 12 hours in the bushes in an attempt to assassinate the former president. And you still have the news media today who are wanting to bicker about, how could Trump blame the rhetoric? How could he blame the rhetoric used by Kamala Harris and the left? Oh, and by the news media. The news media, they want to act like they're shocked and surprised that this happened again, the second time in 2 months. And I received some text messages yesterday and some folks on social media who reached out saying that you're right, that they're not going to stop. I don't know if this will be the final attempt on Trump's life. I mean, I would love to sit here and tell you that this is over, but I think people are going to be more emboldened today than they were after the last attempt. I think the crazy people that are out there that want to do harm to our country and that want to do harm, who want to kill the former president because they believe They believe, because they have been told, they have been indoctrinated into this belief that Trump is Adolf Hitler, that Trump is a dictator, that Trump wants to be a dictator from day one when he's reelected. They have been told this for years. They have been told this for since Trump descended down the escalator. And I know I'm going to sound like a broken record today. From if you were to tune in on that Monday after the first assassination attempt, I'm going to be saying a lot of the same things because they're still accurate, and they're still in play here. We have a news media that is reckless. We have a news media and a Democrat Party that is absolutely reckless in how they speak about this guy. I was watching a little bit of Fox and Friends before I came in, and who is it? The Harold Ford Jr. guy who was trying to say, well, you know, Trump says that Kamala is stupid. No one wants to kill stupid people. There's no one out there that wants to kill stupid people. But if you convince enough people that Trump or anyone is a would-be dictator, basically Hitler, and that they want to end democracy, there are some nut jobs that will put it upon themselves to take that person out. Because they believe you. Because they believe that they are a freedom fighter. This guy who wanted to kill Donald Trump spent time in Ukraine. Now, I can't wait to see what they come out about this, what all comes out about this guy. I want to know where he traveled. I want to know where he has been, who he has spoken with. This guy went to Ukraine to fight. He had pledged to die for Ukraine. This wasn't just somebody who was kept in their in the basement of his parents' house. This was a 53-year-old guy who had pledged to do everything he could to keep Ukraine going. Well, I'm not trying to say that Ukraine is behind this. I'm not saying that at all. But this wasn't just a random guy who was concerned about the Ukraine-Russian war. This goes so much deeper, it seems to me, than just someone who was very concerned about the Ukraine-Russian war. This guy has a background. This guy has a criminal history. Now, I don't know if he's got a social media footprint or not, but I'm hoping we will learn a lot more about him, and though I'm not quite sure, I'm hoping that Florida will find out a lot more about him. I'm hoping that the prosecutors in Florida will maybe do some more investigating than what we can rely on from the FBI, since, well, let's just go with the last shooter. We like to memory hole everything and forget about the assassination attempt that took place 2 months ago. And so I'm hoping we will learn a lot more about this guy, but I'm not convinced that we will. I'm not convinced that we will learn everything there is to know about this shooter from the federal government. Again, how does someone camp out next to a golf course for 12 hours with an AK-47? How does that happen when it's just miles away from Mar-a-Lago, when Donald Trump is going to be on the golf course? How did he know that Trump was going to be on the golf course on Sunday? That wasn't public knowledge. Who told him that Trump was going to be there? How did he know that Trump was going to be there? A lot of questions that obviously still remain, and a lot of questions that need to continue to be asked, and a lot of questions that need to be continue to be asked of the Secret Service. Why was that street not blocked off? Why was someone able to perch for 12 hours next to the golf course, and the Secret Service had no clue until the advance guy was walking and noticed, hey, there's that looks like a muzzle of an AK-47, a guy with a pink shirt on. I will give credit to the U.S. Secret Service for firing on this guy and not putting Trump in the line of sight. I will applaud the Secret Service for that. They stepped up on this one. And they were able to take this guy down. Good job. But why was there not more prep work done on the actual golf course? We'll get into that throughout the program. We'll get into some of the different reaction that's out there. Want to hear from you as well. What are your thoughts after a second assassination attempt on the former president? What does it mean to you? What does it say to you that Trump is having to, that's not just Trump, that we're all seeing this play out. This nation is seeing this play out. This is not good for the soul of the nation. This is not good for our country when you have assassination attempts taking place within 2 months. That's not good for us. It's not good for any nation. I mean, that's a third world country. That doesn't happen here. So, how do you feel about it? What are your thoughts on this? You've heard everybody else sound off all day on it. Now is your opportunity. You can text in at 806-680-2790. That's 806-680-2790. You can also, you can give us a call at 1-800-687-0790. That's 1-800-687-0790. When we come back, we'll get into your phone calls, your text messages, and much more.
The Chad Hastie Show can be heard all over West Texas, weekdays from 5 to 7 p.m. Tune in on News Talk 95.1 and 790 KFYO in Lubbock, News Talk 940 in Amarillo, News Talk 94.7 and 1470 KYYW in Abilene, and in Wichita Falls on News Talk 96.3 and 1290. The Chad Hastie Show. Make it a part of your drive home, weekdays from 5 to 7 p.m.
Clay Travis and Buck Sexton. Tuesday edition, Clay Travis, Buck Sexton show. It'll officially be 7 weeks until Election Day, and Pennsylvanians are beginning to get their ballots. What is the absolute latest on the race, plus the continued fallout of a second attempted assassination of Donald Trump? All that and more. Tuesday edition, Clay and Buck.
Clay Travis and Buck Sexton, tomorrow morning at 11.
All right, back on the Chad HD Show. Thank you very much for tuning in today. You can send in your thoughts on the text line, 806-680-2790. You can also give us a call on the phones at 1-800-687-0790. Let's go out to Abilene. That's where Mike is at. Mike, what's happening today?
How you doing?
Doing great, Dad. Mike. Doing great. How are you?
Mike. I really kind of want to talk about that comment you just made of the third world nation stuff.
Yeah.
Matt, right now you got Kamala Harris wanting to talk about a $25,000 housing grant, another grant if you have a child, and then we've got tax write-offs for low incomes. Social Security is horrible. We take very poor care of our seniors who have given us so much and so much knowledge and so many abilities. Sounds like we're already living in third world nation to me, my friend.
Well, we're not. We still have there's still a lot that's really, really great about the country. But there's
no other place on the planet I want to live.
Yeah, we are importing a lot of the third world, which should be very concerning. But that's why we say this shouldn't happen here, right? In the third world country, a presidential candidate getting shot at, well, that's normal. That doesn't make the news. That just happens there. This shouldn't be happening here.
You are absolutely correct. But, you know, in the old days, Republicans and the Democrats argued like all get out in that courthouse. And whenever they were through arguing, they got up and they went to the same bar and they sat down across from the table with one another and they had a drink and usually something to eat.
Yeah.
And they found out that there were a lot of areas that they really communicated, and now you're not having people sit down. And we've got to get past this point of I hate you simply because.
Well, I agree. And I think that's definitely, and I think social media has played a large part in this. But let's also remember some of the language that's been used here. When you're saying that any of these people are Adolf Hitler, and you convince enough people that they're going to bring the end of quote-unquote democracy to our nation, that's going to inspire people. And that's going to inspire people who are, one, nut jobs, two, people who buy into it altogether, and three, people who believe they're going to be the savior of the nation.
You are absolutely correct.
And we've got to stop it. We've got to stop that.
But in the same circumstance, we've forgotten that Hitler took power by being a friend to the kids. And he was digging the education. And we've got to get some of this government out of the education. They've got to quit continuously teaching people to hate.
Yeah. Hey, Mike Abilene, have a great day.
Have a wonderful day, my friend. Let's get peaceful, sit down, have a steak and a beer.
There you go. I like it. That's from Mike and Abilene. Another texter. Lots of texts coming in. Let's see. Pray it doesn't come all of a sudden dead. Another texter. How was he waiting for 12 hours at the golf course waiting for Trump? It wasn't publicly posted that Trump would be there. And again, this is why I say there has to be, I mean, unless you're just hoping for dumb luck and you're camping out somewhere, to me, this guy had to know that Trump was going to go play golf on Sunday. And that's why he got there extremely early. And he was just waiting. To me, he had to know in advance that Trump was going to be there. So that tells me that somebody either at the golf course or somebody somewhere leaked information that should not have been out there. Another texter, Chad, has an active X profile. He's a full-blown rabid Democrat, has a Harris Walls bumper sticker on his truck. He did. And he was someone who had donated to the Democrats. And he was a Democrat supporter, absolutely. He was someone who hated Donald Trump. His son has been telling the media that he hates Donald Trump, too. So, again, there's a lot of hatred towards Donald Trump in this family. Some other information has come out of people who didn't like this guy, a lot of people who didn't like this guy. Park in California. This guy was hiding in green foliage wearing a pink shirt. Really? Maybe that's why he's not in the Ukraine. Well, he's traveled to Ukraine. He's been in Ukraine. The guy also had set up two backpacks that had the Kevlar plates that if he was shot at and it hit those bags, then he would not have been hit. Again, the guy set up a fairly good area for him to take a shot at Trump. We got very lucky. And when I say we, I don't mean Republicans. I don't mean Trump supporters. I mean the nation. We got lucky. And you just have to wonder, how many times do you get lucky? You know, how many times can this continually happen? You know, we still have a couple of months to go to the election. We still have longer than that to go until the next president is sworn in. And if you think this is going to end, if Trump wins in November, if you think all of these assassination attempts are going to go away. I'm sorry. I've got a really bad feeling that they're just going to amp up. Now, he may have increased Secret Service by then, which is a great thing. But he needs to have increased Secret Service protection right now. Another texter says there doesn't need to be someone on the inside to tell that prospective shooter that Trump was going to be playing golf. One of Trump's closest associates said everybody in that area knows if Trump's airplane is on the tarmac, then he will be on the golf course Sunday morning. And that may be true, too. That may be true. But this took planning. This took a lot of planning and waiting for 12 hours. That's this guy had a plan for a while, it seems like. And hopefully we'll learn more about all this. I hope there was nobody on the inside. But at this point, and I said it after the first assassination attempt on former President Donald Trump, that small circle, that circle of trust needs to get smaller. That circle of trust needs to get even smaller now. When we come back, your phone calls, your text, and much more.
The Chad Hasty Show, weekdays 5 to 7 p.m. Sound off during the show by sending Chad a text at 806-680-2790.
We are the four men between major C. We are the four men. Painful concert number three.
We are the four men. We're 5 and 19.
We are the four men.
Always singing on key.
You love your kids enough to take them to see their favorite band. Love them enough to make sure they're buckled up in the back seat. Show them you love them. Keep them safe. Visit NHTSA.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
This message is from the U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs. Veterans, do you take medication? At VA, prescriptions have a range of copay levels from free to $5, $8, or $11 for a 30-day prescription, depending on your eligibility. Refill by mail, in person, or on VA's mobile app. Sign up at VA.gov or call 1-800-MY-VA-411.
The news and talk of West Texas. News Talk 95.1 and 790 KFYO. You're listening to the Chad Hasty Show.
All right, back on the Chad Hasty Show. Thank you for tuning in today. You can send in your thoughts on the text line at 806-680-2790. Let's see, some text messages that have come in. Here we go again. How many assassination attempts have happened to Democrats in power? Not in 60 years plus. Two tries in 6 weeks on Trump. When will the Dem voters and Dem reporters ever wake up? What a shame. Jody and Seminole. Don't be surprised when this new Trump assassin gets off to the federal custody like Lee Harvey Oswald or Jeffrey Epstein. Dead people don't talk and can't be questioned. Another texter reminding us of Ford, who had two attempts on his life in less than 3 weeks back in 1975. Let's try those back on September 5th of 1975 in Sacramento, both in California, by the way, in Sacramento, and the other September 22nd in San Francisco, when those two assassination attempts went down. Against Ford. And I mean, and then other than that, that's really, you know, obviously, you know, the good news here is that Trump is safe and he was fine and nothing happened. But I mean, this is just, it's way too dangerous. It is just way, way too much. And I think it's perfectly fine and acceptable to pose the question, how much of this is driven by the news media and the Democrat Party that honestly describes Donald Trump as a threat to the United States. And when you go through and you listen to whether it's any of the Sunday morning interview shows, or you just listen to MSNBC at night, you listen to how some of these people speak about Donald Trump. Hell, Kamala Harris, how she has spoken about Trump. Kamala Harris thinks that you need to know that Donald Trump wants to be a dictator on day one. She thinks she wants people to believe that he wants to be a dictator. I mean, this is craziness. You know, when you have Trump saying that Kamala Harris would be a horrible, terrible president, that's true. But that doesn't inflame tensions. That doesn't get anybody upset to the point of wanting to kill someone. Because you're going to be a terrible president, that doesn't make anyone go, well, I've got to stop them. But when you try and convince the nation that Donald Trump is basically Hitler, that Donald Trump wants to implement abortion bans across the United States, that Donald Trump wants to be a dictator beginning on day one, that Donald Trump is a racist and believes that there are very fine people on both sides of the debate in Charlottesville. When you say that he is a threat to democracy, and you continually say that over and over and over again, and you're almost indoctrinating younger people and the dumb masses that are out there. Listen, there are a lot of people who don't pay attention until they see something on the TikTok. They don't pay attention until they see something on Facebook. And these are some of the people that decide, oh, well, we've got to take up arms now against the Republicans. We've got to take up arms against Donald Trump. There is one party that is spewing this hatred and this ideology to raise up people who are going to commit political violence, and it's not the Republicans. I know Kamala Harris would say all day, every day that January 6th, look at what Trump had to do on January 6th. He raised up a mob, an insurrection. When all Trump did was say peacefully march to the Capitol. When you had Capitol police officers who opened the doors of the Capitol to some of the protesters. Now, were there protesters who also hit cops? Yes. But this was, by and large, a very nonviolent protest compared to what we saw during some of the BLM protests, and compared to what we're seeing from these crazy Democrats who want to shoot at Trump. And a texter asking, what can people do? What is it that people can do about this? The only thing I can really say that people need to do is to pray. Is to pray not only for Donald Trump, but to pray for this country. This country is under attack. This country is, Donald Trump is under attack. This country is under attack. We are under attack from an evil force out there right now. I truly believe that. And when you're under attack from an evil force, you need to get closer to God. And you look at what has happened in the last 2 months. I think the only reason why Donald Trump is still alive is because God has other plans for him. I mean, you just, you can't buy luck. The way Trump has had it. I mean, this has been a God thing. And I think he knows that. I pray he knows that. And I would say for the nation needs to be in a state of prayer. Because there's a lot of evil in the world. We know that. We know there's a ton of evil in the world. And whatever evil forces that are out there, whatever you want to say, they are absolutely right now attacking this country because this the evil that is out there, they don't want Trump to win. The evil that's out there doesn't want a Trump presidency. They don't want freedom in America. That's not what evil wants. And I would just pray for Trump, pray for his family, pray for the nation, pray for us as a people, and ask for God's protection over this country because we need it. And if Trump does win in November, you're probably going to have to double down on those prayers. Because I wish I could sit here and tell you that I think this is over. I don't think you're going to have another assassination attempt on Trump. But I told you 2 months ago that I thought this was going to continue to happen. And I believe it's going to continue to happen still. Because you have a media that they really don't care. They'll act shocked for a little bit. They'll act shocked. They'll act surprised. But they're not shocked. They're not surprised. And you have the left, they'll come out for a day and go, well, we need to look at our political rhetoric. And then 2 days from now, they'll be heated right back up. So, yeah, pray. And then vote. And then after that, pray a little bit more. Well, what can you do now? Pray. Pray for our country. Pray for our nation. See a text that came in. Notice, they never talk about taking guns away when they're used against Trump. Yeah, you don't hear that. No, you don't hear the news media say we've got to get rid of the AK-47 today. And even if they did, I'd say no. Because the gun wasn't the problem. The gun is an evil person who has lost their mind due to Democrat talking points. 806-680-2790. That's 806-680-2790. You can send in your thoughts on the text line. When we come back, your phone calls, your text, and much more.
The Titan of Texas Talk Radio, Chad Hastie.
Talking with newsmakers and about the issues that matter to you. The Chad Hastie Show, weekdays from 5 to 7 p.m. Chad's show is also digital with the Chad Hastie Show podcast. The Chad Hastie Show podcast can be downloaded on Apple Podcasts, Amazon Music, Spotify, and the Radio On Demand page at KFYO.com. The Chad Hastie Show, all across Texas during your drive home, weekdays from 5 to 7 p.m.
Clay Travis and Buck Sexton. Tuesday edition, Clay Travis, Buck Sexton show. It'll officially be 7 weeks until Election Day, and Pennsylvanians are beginning to get their ballots. What is the absolute latest on the race, plus the continued fallout of a second attempted assassination of Donald Trump? All that and more. Tuesday edition, Clay and Buck.
Clay Travis and Buck Sexton, tomorrow morning at 11.
All right, back on the Chad HD Show. Thank you very much for tuning in today. Texter saying that they think there was a rather feeble attempt against Obama. Don't remember the details, maybe climbing the fence outside the White House lawn or something like that. There were shots fired at the White House while Obama was in office. Then there are the attempts that you never hear about. The attempts that you don't hear about, they don't make news. Secret Service, finds out what's going on, and they shut it down. So there were attempts on Obama's life. There were attempts on other, past presidents' lives. Rarely do they get as close as we've seen the last 2 months against the former president. And I think that's what is so concerning out there for many. 806-680-2790. Texter, I agree, Chad. My preacher is doing a 4-part series on how to be Christian in an election year or any year. Very convicting for me. This particular scripture was the overall theme of yesterday's sermon. And I think a lot of churches should be talking about the times that we live in right now and what we need to be doing. And yes, part of that is voting. A lot of it, though, is praying for our nation and praying, for wisdom. We need to be praying for wisdom. We need to be praying for the health of our leaders. We need to be praying for the health of our nation. There's a lot that, yes, Christians can do during an election year. And of course, one of one of the biggest things you could do after praying is taking action and getting out and voting in November. And that's something that voters are going to have to do, that Republicans are going to have to do. They're going to have to get out and vote. I got a story that we'll get to in detail in a little bit deeper in the next hour about the Senate race here in Texas. The Senate race here in Texas, if you believe all the polls, and I'm not sure I necessarily do, but if you believe all the polls, show a closer race than really what it should be here. Do I believe Texas is turning blue in this election? No. Do I believe that the Cruz-Allred race may be a little bit closer than what it should be? Yes. And there's not a lot of campaigning going on. There's not a lot of crisscrossing the state going on. So we kind of forget about this Senate race. It's in the background. We really don't see a lot on it. But Democrats are spending a lot of money. And, they're wanting to try to lull the Republicans to a false sense of security on this Senate seat, I believe. Again, you're going to have to get out and vote. You're going to have to get out and vote. You're going to have to pray for the country. You're going to have to get involved. You have to make sure that your friends vote, that your neighbors vote. Not those neighbors, but the other neighbors. Make sure they get out and vote. Speaking of neighbors, they're not neighbors of mine. I just saw them. We were, my wife and I, we were driving the other night on Slide Road here in Lubbock. And I saw two signs out there that just made me shake my head. I wanted to do a U-turn to make sure I saw them the correct way. There were two signs: Republicans for Harrison Walls. And it made me shake my head because I sit there and go, why? What would, as a Republican, what makes you go, I need to go and vote for Kamala Harris, even if you can't bring yourself to voting for Donald Trump out of this idea that you're better than everyone else. What makes you go, as a Republican, I'm going to go and vote for Kamala Harris? What exactly, because Texas ain't turning blue. And in theory, you don't want Texas to turn blue. If you're still out there saying that you're a Republican. I'm trying to get into the mindset of how someone could say, I'm a Republican and I'm voting for Kamala Harris. What do you agree with her on? What policy do you agree with Kamala Harris on? Where is it that you look at her and go, yes, she deserves my vote. She has captured my vote. I'd love to know. Again, it was just two little campaign signs that I saw right outside this house. I was driving down Slide Road. Republicans for Harris and Walls. What exactly draws you to voting for Kamala Harris? We'll be right back.
The Chad Hastie Show, a presentation of the Texas Town Square Media Network. The views and opinions expressed during the Chad Hastie Show are not necessarily the views of this station staff, management, advertisers, or Town Square Media. Broadcasting from the great state of Texas, this is the Chad Hastie Show. News and views with a Lone Star perspective. You can sound off during the show by sending Chad a text at 806-680-2790. That's 806-680-2790. Or call in at 1-800-687-0790. Now, here's Chad Hastie.
Welcome back to the Chad Hastie Show. Appreciate you being out there. You can send in your thoughts on the text line at 806-680-2790. That's 806-680-2790. You can always get in touch with us, sound off on any of the topics that you'd like to sound off on. And you can also, of course, text in. You can call in. You can find us on social media. Follow me on X, at Chad Hastie Radio on X. You can also download the Chad Hastie Show podcast. It's available after every show. Just find wherever your favorite podcast platform is. Search for the Chad Hastie Show, and boom. You can follow and subscribe. It'll download right to your phone or whatever program that you're using. And you can listen to the podcast anytime. Also, I encourage you to download or subscribe and download the Current and Cask podcast. It's a podcast that I do along with Matt Martin. And we discuss whiskey news, current events, a little bit of sports we'll throw in there. And, of course, we do whiskey reviews as well, so you can subscribe and follow. It's absolutely free. Anywhere you get podcasts from, go ahead and do that. Current and Cask is the name of that podcast. So, yeah, we got that out of the way. You can send in your thoughts on the text line, 806-680-2790. That's 806-680-2790. 680-2790. Let's see. Nick, earlier you asked me if I've seen Scary Movie. What was that all? Jump on the microphone. Well, we haven't even spoken to Nick yet today. Are you doing okay, Nick?
Yeah, I'm doing great today.
Yeah. I'm sorry we've ignored you.
You
I
have,
apologize.
You know, I've been bottling it up.
Yeah, I know you have.
Very healthy. One of these days, it'll come out.
Yeah, you'll get very mad.
So yeah. This was a question I was asking you. I asked you if you've seen Scary Movie.
Yeah.
The movie Scary Movie.
Yeah. Yeah. No. I've
okay.
Seen
okay.
It.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. It was. This is completely irrelevant now. But there was.
Okay.
We were listening to something. We were playing some music as we do during the break. And there's a song. I was gonna say this song reminds me of blah 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 blah. But you blew it.
You didn't address
the question until way after. So forget it. You know, it's okay.
It's only been 20 minutes since you asked the question. Yeah.
It's okay. I'll just stay in my little hole here, tucked away.
I thought that I maybe said something about the movie that, you know, I don't know.
No, you didn't.
I didn't know if there was a connection. Okay.
No.
Sorry about that. Yeah. But you're doing good. You're doing fine.
I'm doing fine today.
Okay.
I was going to tell you, it's one of those days where in the back of my head, I know I'm forgetting something.
Yeah.
But I have no idea what it is. And I'm hoping it's nothing major. I'm telling myself, if it were something major, I would know by now, given that it's 6 p.m.
Probably true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I don't know what I'm
forgetting. Unless it's something with your relationship, in which case you'll know about that later.
Yeah.
If you forgot.
I don't think it is, but if I forgot, I forgot. So I don't know.
Yeah.
But work related, I don't think I forgot anything.
Yeah. No, you should be fine.
Yeah. We're on air.
Yeah.
So, you know.
That's all that matters. All that matters. Yeah, exactly. We're good.
Yeah.
Let's see. How about we go to the phone? Let's find out what's happening. We've got HR in Lubbock. What's happening today, HR?
Fast, quick in a hurry. I'm going to ask you a quick question, get your take on it, and I'll hang up and listen. The thing that's going on in Springfield, today on Fox, I saw two different deals. I looked at MSNBC. They had people that were saying that what Trump was saying was ludicrous, and you know it has no truth to it.
Are you talking about the dogs and the cats?
Yeah, that and the Haitians, overwhelming their schools and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And then when I watched Fox today, there was people on there saying that they were overwhelmed and that one guy said that his son was hit, and another lady, her mother-in-law, something, she was hit. So you got two stories. One says that it happened. The other one says that it did not happen. My question for you is, what do you think's going on here? And I'll hang up and listen.
Well, I think you've got a couple. I think one. So the eating the dogs, eating the cats deal. This started, oh my goodness, weeks and weeks ago. I believe I'm right on this. I believe I'm correct on this. If not, someone can correct me here. But you had a person who got up in front of a city hall meeting or town council meeting, whatever, and had said that there were people that he had seen people eating ducks out of like a community pond. And from there, there were other reports that would pop up that people's pets were going missing. There is no question in my mind that this Springfield, Ohio, this small town of Springfield, Ohio, has been overwhelmed by Haitians who have been sent to Springfield. They have been bused there. They have been dropped off there. I have seen numerous stories. From different agencies that show that this town has been completely overwhelmed by Haitian immigrants that have been sent there by the federal government, and so that is happening. It has been a problem with crime. There has been a problem with not having enough city services. There's issues. J.D. Vance has said that he has heard from some constituents, and he says, look, I don't know if it's real or not. I don't know. I'm just telling you, my office has had these reports. My office has been contacted by people who have had their pets go missing and they wind up dead. And they never had this problem years ago. Their pets would not go missing. We didn't have any problems like that at all. Now all of a sudden they're having problems. What's going on? There was another reporting organization that came out over the weekend that said they had video of some guys who were cooking a cat, basically, barbecuing a cat. And it was in a different town in Ohio, but this was a video that they had received. There was a New York Post article that came out today, maybe yesterday, that police are having to crack down. Now, this is in New York, but police are having to crack down sacrifices, people who are immigrants, who are using animals in sacrifices, including cats, and I think pigs were involved as well, maybe. Have to go back and look. So, how much of it is, yes, there are Haitian immigrants running around Springfield, Ohio, chomping down on cats and dogs. I don't think it's happening all over the place. Do I think that maybe there are some reports? I'm sure there are some. Somebody came up with it somehow. And there was a guy at a town hall meeting who said that he had seen something. Now, is it you walk outside with your kitty cat and, all of a sudden someone's going to run by and grab the kitty cat and start barbecuing and filleting the cat? Probably not. But it has drawn a lot of attention to the plight of this town, which has absolutely been overwhelmed by these migrants. And some have said that's the entire point of all of this, is that nobody would care about this town if it were not for the outlandish stories of people eating cats and dogs. And that there are many towns like Springfield, Ohio, that have been completely overwhelmed by migrants that have been brought in by the United States and people who are just dumped off in these cities. And that's the important story. That's the important piece here. And there have been numerous reports of, yes, this Ohio town being completely overwhelmed by people who have been brought here by the United States and resettled in these areas. 806-680-2790. And let's remember here that some people who are brought here from other nations. I just told you about this New York Post story that talked about animal sacrifices. There are people here who will bring their customs. And what they do in that country, they will bring it here. So don't be surprised if some of this is true. 806-680-2790. When we come back, your phone calls, your texts, and more.
The Chad Hasty Show can be heard all over West Texas, weekdays from 5 to 7 p.m. Tune in on News Talk 95.1 and 790 KFYO in Lubbock. News Talk 940 in Amarillo, News Talk 94.7 and 1470 KYYW in Abilene, and in Wichita Falls on News Talk 96.3 and 1290. The Chad Hasty Show. Make it a part of your drive home. Weekdays from 5 to 7 p.m.
Clay Travis and Buck Sexton. Tuesday edition, Clay Travis, Buck Sexton Show. It'll officially be 7 weeks until Election Day, and Pennsylvanians are beginning to get their ballots. What is the absolute latest on the race, plus the continued fallout of a second attempted assassination of Donald Trump? All that and more. Tuesday edition, Clay and Buck.
Clay Travis and Buck Sexton, tomorrow morning at 11.
Chad Hasty Show. Thank you for tuning in today. You can send in your thoughts on the text line, 806-680-2790. That's 806-680-2790. The Hill with a story out today. Democrats build momentum in Texas Senate race. Democrats see new signs they could make inroads in the traditionally deep red state of Texas. New polling suggests the party is competitive in Texas, both on the presidential level and in the race between Cruz and Democrat challenger Colin Allred. It's fueling hopes that this could be the year the state finally trends in the party's direction. Pollster Brent Lloyd said, quote, anybody that says it just doesn't happen in Texas doesn't happen until it does. Allred said, Brent Lloyd, Allred scores an upset in the Senate race contest between Cruz and Allred, whose entry last year shifted the Cook Political Report's rating of the Senate seat from solid to likely Republican, is one of a small handful that has emerged as unexpectedly competitive in the high-stakes fight for the Senate this fall. Cruz fended off struck Democrat challenge 6 years ago when O'Rourke came within 3 percentage points of flipping the seat. O'Rourke's bid benefited from the broader blue wave in the midterm election that year, and some in the state are skeptical that Allred can snag the energy he needs to finish the job this cycle. In 2022, Governor Abbott defeated O'Rourke's bid for governor by double digits. But several recent polls show Cruz struggling across the 50% mark, making the Senate race here a potential bright spot for the Democrats. Well, if you're Ted Cruz or a Ted Cruz fan in the closing months of the election, you're not at 50%. You're not closing that margin up towards 50%. It's going to be problematic, Lloyd said. Two new surveys have found Allred at the incumbent's heels within the margin of error. An Emerson College polling poll this week put Allred just 4 points behind in a University of Houston, Texas Southern University survey late last month, rivals a mere two-point race. Republican former Rep. Liz Cheney also stepped in with a surprise endorsement of Allred. That won't matter. Allred's momentum to defeat Ted Cruz continues to build, his campaign said in a statement touting new polling data and Cheney's backing. The Democrat notably outraised Cruz in the second quarter, though Cruz had a larger war chest. So, is Colin Allred really a threat to Ted Cruz? I don't think he is as big of a threat as Beto O'Rourke was. But Beto finished about 3 percentage points behind Ted Cruz. Ted Cruz, they can compare Ted Cruz to Greg Abbott's numbers all they want, but Ted Cruz traditionally underperforms other statewide Republican officials. There are Republicans who don't like Ted Cruz. There are Republicans who are tired of Ted Cruz seemingly ignoring Texas and Texas voters. I've had a few people who have actually texted in today and even before today asking, why is it Ted Cruz campaigning in West Texas? It's a great question. I think it's a the best response that I can get out of the Cruz campaign and some of the people within it is that Cruz apparently will be campaigning heavily in October, and that's great to make the final push into November, and I think it's probably enough to get the job done. But I would love to see Ted Cruz win by 10 points. I would love to see Ted Cruz win by double digits. And he may. It may happen. Colin Allred is not a good candidate. He's not a good campaigner. He hasn't really campaigned except for in the largest cities in Texas. And even there, he hasn't really campaigned that often. He hasn't really done a lot. He hasn't stepped on any toes. He's not really getting any traction whatsoever with the news media. He's been a ghost on the campaign trail. But when you have two candidates who are both ghosts on the campaign trail, this is kind of what you get. People don't, they're not talking about the Senate race. It's people are forgetting there's even a Senate race out there. And they're focused on the White House. When we need to have people also focused on the Senate race and campaigning and out there campaigning for Ted Cruz. And Ted Cruz needs to remember that this is the red firewall in this part of Texas. This is the firewall. This is where he needs to really, really put up big numbers. There's going to be a time, and I don't know when it's going to happen. I don't know. I'm not predicting it's going to happen anytime soon, but there will be a time, most likely, where a candidate is going to ignore the firewall. They're going to ignore the voters in this area of the state, and the voters just won't get out for them. And you may see a Democrat win a statewide seat at some point. Again, I don't think it's going to happen this year. I don't think it's going to happen in the midterms, but at some point it's going to happen. Texas politicians are not used to having to campaign heavily in the rural areas. They're not used to it. They're not used to having to make up votes in the larger cities like some of the other more purple states. And those politicians are used to it. But at some point, it may get to that, where they're going to have to become familiar with making up votes in the big country, making up votes in West Texas, making up votes in the Panhandle. Because Dallas, it's not getting any redder. Houston is not getting any redder. Austin's definitely not getting any redder. Up and down I-35, it's getting bluer and bluer and bluer. We'll be right back.
Call in to the Chad Hastie Show at 1-800-687-0790. The Chad Hastie Show, broadcasting on the Texas Town Square Media Network.
Speeding tickets aren't cheap, and they can make your insurance rates go up too. So if you don't remember anything else from this commercial, remember this. Slow down or pay up. Also, if law enforcement pulls you over for speeding, they'll check your license and registration. So be ready for that. Basically, if you ever wonder if speeding is worth it, the answer is pretty obvious. No way. Speeding is dangerous and expensive, so slow down or pay up. Be safe, drive smart. A message from TxDOT.
I'm Scarlett Johansson. My family relied on public assistance to help provide meals for us. These meals fueled my involvement in theater and the arts as a child, which fostered my love for acting. The Feeding America Network of Food Banks helps millions of people put food on the table. You can join the movement to end hunger by donating, volunteering, and advocating. Because when people are fed, futures are nourished. Join the movement to end hunger at feedingamerica.org/act now. Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
The news and talk of West Texas. News Talk 95.1 and 790 KFYO. Chad Hastie, talking the news at the start, middle, and end of your drive home, and when news breaks. This is the Chad Hastie Show.
All right, back on the Chad Hastie Show. Appreciate everybody tuning in today. By the way, if you were wondering if the Taylor Swift endorsement has hurt Donald Trump, news coming out this evening, most in a new survey says Taylor Swift's endorsement has had no impact on their vote. Pop star Taylor Swift and her presidential endorsement was highly coveted, but it may have had little impact on the race, according to ABC News. Said Swift's support for Vice President Harris will not influence how they vote. About 81% of those surveyed said they will have said Taylor Swift will have no impact on how they vote. In fact, you want to know the best part of this? In the poll by ABC News, 81% of those surveyed said that Taylor Swift's endorsement of Kamala Harris will have no difference in how they vote. 6% said it makes them more likely to vote for Kamala Harris. What do you think about that, Nick? 6% of people said it makes them more likely to vote for Kamala. 13% of people said it makes them less likely to support Kamala Harris. How about that? That's not what you want. See, if you're Kamala Harris, you don't want more people to now to be less likely to support you. You want your number to be a lot higher that'll support you. Only 6%. This is why, for Taylor Swift, just why? Why even endorse people? It's just, listen to Patrick Mahomes. Just do what Michael Jordan did back in the day. Tell people to go and vote. Your job is to entertain people. If you're Taylor Swift, that's your job. Your job is to entertain people. Nobody cares what you think about politics. They don't. At least 81% of people do not care what you think about politics. And in fact, you may make some people angry. Some people who may have purchased music from you or go to your concerts. That's why Patrick Mahomes, very smart. Patrick Mahomes sits there and goes, you know what? Republicans watch football. Democrats watch football. Republicans buy the shoes that I'm selling. Democrats buy the shoes that I'm selling. Everyone wants to buy the stuff that I'm selling. Everyone get out and vote. Not my job to tell you. My job is to get out there, be a great quarterback, be a great husband, be a great father. That's my job. That's the lane I'm in. Michael Jordan, he knew. He didn't want to upset anybody. He told people, go and vote. But I do think it's hilarious that Taylor Swift's endorsement doesn't help Kamala Harris at all. And I didn't think it would. But that 13% of people, there are more people, double the people are more likely to now not support Kamala Harris because of Taylor Swift's endorsement. It's pretty good. That's pretty good. 806-680-2790. By the way, we do have some national days today. We have National Step Family Day. So that's today. National Choose Your Own Chocolate Day. It's also National Barber Day. You want to make sure you have, you want to make sure you got a good barber. Good place to go and get a haircut. You want to make sure you got that. Today is also National Tattoo Story Day. And so I'm wondering, for those out there, I'm wondering how many of the listeners have a tattoo that they've got a good story about. Text in if you do. Like if you got a tattoo that has a special meaning behind it, text us and let us know. 806-680-2790. 2790. Nick, I'm thinking you have no tattoos. Is that correct? Is that a easy thing to predict there?
That is pretty easy. I do not have any tattoos.
Would you ever get one?
I'm going to say no. I don't think I ever will. I do not foresee any day in the future when I decide, you know what? I'm gonna put some ink on my body, I think. I don't know. Shake things up.
What if your fiancé
wants matching tattoos?
Wants matching tattoos in the future.
Well, I will say she is also someone who will definitely not get any.
But if
that were to happen.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be opposed to like a really small, kind of tucked away, like that, you know, like on like my, I don't know, my forearm or shoulder, something a little small. Like, 'cause to me, the whole point of a tattoo is the meaning behind it.
Sure.
You know, of course you can go off and you can put whatever you want on your body. And I mean that, whatever, that's entirely up to you. But if I were to get a tattoo, it would have to really, really mean something.
Yeah.
Like a family member, who has died or something, or something that's really close to me. So, and again, I wouldn't want to like the back of my hand or my neck.
Nothing on your face?
Yeah, maybe not my face.
You're saying you don't want to get your face tattooed?
Yeah, maybe not. Yeah. Okay. Because it's again, it's for me.
Right.
If I were to do it, it would be for me. So it'd be something private, something just on me. But sure, the window is open. I'm not saying never.
Right.
But right now, no.
is a no. Yeah, yeah. Okay. All right. Yeah, no, I'm with you on that. Though I don't mind tattoos. I don't mind tattoos. I think, you know, if you want to do it, do it. Yeah, that's fine. And I do like some of the tattoos that, you know, when someone has a story behind it, you know, and, you know, that's pretty good. I like that. Let's see. Texter Tim in Wichita Falls. Dallas radio station reported earlier today that the Haitian community in the Metroplex has been harvesting geese from local community lakes and parks. One witness said that he saw a man with four in his possession walking down the street. Another text. Judging by the Harris Walls signs I've seen here, crews better not take this area for granted. Yeah, and you know, again, as Lubbock grows, people are going to like, they're not going to like hearing this. As Lubbock grows, the bluer it's going to get. I know. People are going to get mad about that comment. They're going to get upset about it. But for those of you in Lubbock, let me ask you this question. Is the city more conservative now or less? Are they more or less conservative now than they were in 2001? When I moved here don't blame me, but when I moved here in 2001, so if you've been here since, you know, the year 2001, if you've been here longer than that, think about the last 20 years or so. Is the city government, is the city overall, do you believe the city has gotten more conservative or less conservative in the last 20 years? Just think about it. Let me know what you think on the text line, 806-680-2790. You can do the same thing for those of you in Amarillo. Amarillo has grown as well. What do you think? As is Amarillo, are they more conservative now or less conservative now than they were 20 years ago? Now think about your city councils. Think about your school boards. Think about your county commissioners. Are they more conservative now or more conservative back then? And you just have to think 20 years. That's it. For those who have been around in the city for 20 years. 806-680-2790. When we come back, your phone calls, your text, and more.
The Titan of Texas Talk Radio. Chad Hasty.
Talking with newsmakers and about the issues that matter to you. The Chad Hasty Show, weekdays from 5 to 7 p.m. Chad's show is also digital with the Chad Hasty Show podcast. The Chad Hasty Show podcast can be downloaded on Apple Podcasts, Amazon Music, Spotify, and the Radio On Demand page at KFYO.com. The Chad Hasty Show, all across Texas during your drive home, weekdays from 5 to 7 p.m.
Clay Travis and Buck Sexton. Tuesday edition, Clay Travis, Buck Sexton show. It'll officially be 7 weeks until Election Day, and Pennsylvanians are beginning to get their ballots. What is the absolute latest on the race, plus the continued fallout of a second attempted assassination of Donald Trump? All that and more. Tuesday edition, Clay and Buck.
Clay Travis and Buck Sexton, tomorrow morning at 11. Cool.
Always worried about things like that. Well, she said it's all gonna end, and it might as well be my fault. And she only sleeps when it's raining, and she screams, and her voice is straining. She says, baby,
back on the Chad Hasty Show. J.D. Vance has posted a really, really good statement on X. This is what he had to say, and I'll try to get through it all here. It's a fairly long post, but I'll try to get through it here. J.D. Vance, yesterday Donald J. Trump nearly lost his life. An armed gunman waited for him in the bushes. He brought a GoPro camera to record it. A Secret Service agent spotted the barrel of a gun through the fence and shot at the gunman. The gunman fled. He was caught. And now we will slowly learn about him and his motive. President Trump is my running mate and my friend, but he is, more importantly, a father and a grandfather to people who love him very much. And I want him to have many, many more years with his family. Selfishly, I'd like many, many more with my own. I admire the president for calling for peace and calm. The rhetoric is out of control. He nearly got Steve Scalise and many others killed a few years ago. Nearly got Donald Trump killed twice. But I want to say something about yesterday's news and how it illuminates the difference between vigorous debate and violent rhetoric. What we know so far, Kamala Harris has said democracy is on the line in her race against President Trump. The gunman agreed and used the exact same phrase. He had a Kamala Harris bumper sticker on his truck. He was obsessed with Ukraine's fight for democracy and absorbed many unhinged views about the Russia-Ukraine war. His name is Ryan Ruth, and he donated 19 times to Democrat causes and zero to Republican ones. How do you think the Democrats and their media allies would respond if a 19-time Republican donor tried to kill a Democrat official? It's a question that answers itself. For years, Kamala Harris's campaign surrogates have said things like Trump has to be eliminated, and have their media allies responded, or how have their media allies responded to the second assassination attempt on Donald Trump in as many months? NBC News called the attempted assassination a golf club incident. The LA Times told us Trump targeted at a golf club. The USA Today's top story of the fold headline is Hope in America. They published a piece, a preposterous letter to the editor, arguing that Trump brings these assassination attempts on himself. CNN's Dana Bash, who just yesterday bizarrely accused me of inciting a bomb threat, said today that the Harris rhetoric didn't motivate Ruth, even though he echoed the rhetoric explicitly. PBS's weekend show perfectly illustrates the double standard of Kamala Harris's media friends. After spending 30 seconds on the second assassination attempt on Trump, they then focus on the real danger, me and Trump, who are, according to them, personally responsible for bomb threats against Springfield. Of course, I repeatedly condemn those threats, and reports today suggest they came from a foreign country, not, as the media suggested, a deranged Trump fan. The double standard is breathtaking. Trump and I are, by their account, are directly responsible for bomb threats from foreign countries. Why? Because we had the audacity to repeat what residents told us about their problems in their town. Meanwhile, Harris allies call for Trump to be eliminated as the media publishes arguments that he deserved to be shot. This seems like a double standard, but at a deep level, it's entirely consistent. Consider Springfield, citizens telling us there are problems. These include the undeniable truths of higher car accidents, unaffordable housing, eviction for residents, overcrowding hospitals, overstressed schools, and rising rates of disease. They also include infamous pet stories, which again, multiple people have spoken about either on video or to me or to my staff. Kamala Harris's first strategy was to ignore these people and their concerns. Yes, she had prevented the deportation of millions of illegal aliens, and some of them made their way to Springfield, but it was a small town with no voice. Some of the local leadership even loved the cheap labor. So the suffering of thousands of American citizens were ignored. Their next move with these stories is censorship in Springfield. A psychopath calls in a bomb threat, so they blame that on President Trump and me. The threat of violence is disgraceful, of course. I'm not going to have time to finish it, but it goes on. Find it on X and read it. It is fantastic. Very, very good from J.D. Vance, and I retweeted it for those who follow me. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Stay safe, stay healthy. God bless you all. We'll see you back here tomorrow at 5 p.m., where we'll continue the fallout from the attempted assassination attempt. We'll also get to some local headlines that we missed out on today, some other national news as well. We'll see you tomorrow.
The Chad Hasty Show, a presentation of the Texas Town Square Media Network. The views and opinions expressed during the Chad Hasty Show are not necessarily the views of this station's staff, management, advertisers, or Town Square Media.